Hey guys, Level Cap here. Today is Monday, which means it's time for an episode of Loadout, the series where you guys, the viewers, get to pick a gun and customization for me to use. The way you do this is you leave a comment down below letting me know what you'd like me to run with, and I will pick one of the top rated comments for the next episode. Today's top comment comes from Wanawa. He says, "Lost the Smoke Monster. Support class silenced MG4 with FLIR and no laser, silenced M39R pistol, smoke grenades, ammo box, and claymores. Your aim is to use smoke grenades and see through them with your FLIR scope. You're the invisible death. Also, you can hide claymores in the smoke where death lurks. You can also use it to distract your enemies and pretend you're coming from there, then back rage and release hell. Don't use laser sight to prevent being spotted. I'd be happy if you consider this. Have fun." Now, I was really looking forward to trying out this setup. It was something I had thought about doing before. I'm sure a lot of you guys have thought about using FLIR scopes in combination with smoke grenades, and what better way to do it than with a silenced machine gun? That seems like the proper way to deal a massive amount of damage and not let the enemy know where you're coming from. Now, this setup worked with varying degrees of success. It pretty much depended on who I was playing against, what map I was playing on, and there is one major flaw with this setup, and I'll get into it in a little bit, and it's really, really depressing, and I'm hoping that DICE can sort of fix some of the issues with it. Here I am on Hainan Resort, probably couldn't figure that out from the beginning of this clip. I'm creating a little smoke cloud around myself to try and make it harder to pinpoint my exact location, although you'll see in this situation the smoke kind of wears off and that guy takes me down. Now, because of the nature of smoke grenades and how short term they are, I found it almost impossible to make this loadout work on any map other than Operation Locker with a large player base, or at least a decent amount of players that I could really guarantee that almost all avenues of attack were going to be approached, and I could just pick one hallway, smoke it up, peek down that hallway with the FLIR sights, and take out my targets. One of the big issues with this setup is that smoke grenades themselves are pretty crappy. Not only do they not provide full seal cover in many situations, but the duration of the smoke is very, very limited, so you have to continuously throw them, which leaves you vulnerable to oncoming attacks. A lot of times when people see a big smoke cloud, they'll charge through it, and if you're in the middle of throwing a smoke grenade, it leaves you totally vulnerable, because it does actually take a while to bring your weapon back up and ready to fire after you've thrown one. Again, Operation Locker, something about the map design, how dark it is in the corridors, allows you to really confine that smoke and put two or three smoke grenades down in the exact same spot, giving you a long visible area that's totally blocked off. But in larger open maps, smoke grenades provide you with such limited cover that they become pretty much useless unless you're just throwing them at your feet, in which case all you are is just a guy hiding in a small puff of smoke, and it's relatively easy to figure out where you are. Now, the real issue with this setup here is that smoke is bugged out. You can spot people through it. As you can see here, I'm able to spot this player through a complete wall of smoke. There's like four or five smoke grenades down there. He just keeps throwing them. I can see exactly where he is, and I have no problem just zooming down my sights, shooting at that triangle, and taking him out through the smoke. So any seasoned player who's probably gonna hit the Q button anyway when you come around a corner is gonna spot you. So that's a massive, massive issue with smoke. If you can spot people through it, you'll see here it kind of works on and off. It's working a tiny bit, but it still tells me where that person is. Also, I can see exactly where the smoke grenades are coming from as they are deployed. So again, it doesn't provide a very good visual cover. To me, this makes smoke grenades worthless, and I think that's honestly a bug. I don't think DICE intended to have you be able to spot through grenades, smoke grenades, but for some reason you can. So I would hope that DICE plans on fixing this as an issue. The other thing that I just feel that smoke grenades are just underpowered. You know, the longevity of them is a real pain in the butt. There's a fine line between being able to spam something and then it just not being too powerful enough. I think it would be cool if they allowed smoke grenades to not only disperse more smoke, but last longer, and then just have ammo boxes take a little bit longer to recharge them, so you can't spam them as much. This in turn would make players have to think a little bit more carefully about where they throw each individual smoke grenade, as it's going to be a little bit longer before you get the next one. So less spammy, longer lasting, and it allows you to aim down sight and actually engage in the combat for a longer period of time before you have to essentially throw your next smoke grenade. Now, I couldn't play this setup very much because it was really aggravating, and I'm just showing you the clips where it was remotely successful. Most of the time, I would lay down smoke and just immediately die, get shot through it, and have no tactical advantage whatsoever. So ultimately, this setup is a complete fail, not because of the concept is awesome, but because you can simply spot through smoke, and therefore it becomes worthless against any sort of player that actually knows how to spot and uses that function frequently. One thing that I actually didn't end up running into was somebody trying to counter this with flares. As you know, flare sights will not function very well. If there's a flare in the scene, it will pretty much white out the whole scope, but I think I just wasn't effective enough with this loadout for anybody to try and counter it. V40 minis were more effective than flares at taking me out. So overall, I think this loadout is a good concept, but it just doesn't work because of the bugs in the game, and it's a lot more effort than it is payout. So I would recommend avoiding this loadout until the bugs are fixed. As always, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time. This is Level Cap, signing off.